CFS Warriors, it's Victoria coming to you from Maui just after sunset. It is so beautiful, but I'm sorry, I think my background is getting really dark. I just want to talk to you tonight about movement is life. It is so important that we get movement and that we get the blood moving in our body and especially up to our brain. First, I want to just give you three tips. So the first one is to start and go forward incrementally. Whatever movement you start with, give it a few days and make sure your body's responding well with that, that it's not too much, and then begin to progress very incrementally. It might seem really slow, but at least you are moving forward. And that would include if you're doing dry brushing to get the lymphatic system moving and the circulation going, that you start very gently with maybe just one area of your body, and then go again the next day or skip a day and see how you're doing with it. So you don't just come in and start all the stuff at once. You wanna very incrementally move forward. As I did, as you probably know from watching my videos, started with a 3-minute walk, then would add a minute and just continue to progress till I worked to a 10-minute walk, a 20-minute walk, and that was over the course of several months, if not a year or two, okay? But now I'm out walking beaches and having fun in Maui, okay? So you gotta start somewhere. So the second thing I wanna encourage you to do is think about the concept of behavior activation. And what that means is when you're feeling stuck, think of something that you'd really love to do, because that's gonna get you moving, something that you would enjoy doing. And that will activate your momentum. So basically, you know, you might start with, I don't know, what would be something you'd love to do? Just think about it and then go, okay, let me start with that rather than all these chores I need to do. Because what happens is when you do something you love, then you can begin to add the other things in because you've gotten moving, right? And so that forward motion is so important. And the third thing is you start getting up and about and moving is don't do the rush and crush or the cram and jam. And I did this so much in my life and I still have to watch that I don't do this behavior pattern of trying to stuff so much into a short time that then I'm in a rush and my heart rate's going, the blood pressure's up, and it's stress hormones are cascading through the body. So we want to avoid that at all costs. So, you know, I even do this with like the closet, cramming things in the closet. I'm learning how space is really important. And one of the techniques that Gupta does that I really love is a slow motion technique. And so he has you do everything in slow motion for like, you know, just maybe 20 minutes. And that way you're getting used to a more relaxed pace. You're not putting pressure on yourself and you're not putting that foot in your back. Okay, so another thing you can do is just make a decision that you will never rush again. And that will go a long way towards bringing down that stressful sympathetic nervous system, fight or flight mode, and bringing yourself more into the parasympathetic relaxed mode, which is so important for our bodies to be in a healing state. So anyway, warriors, hope that helps. Remember, life's not over, it's starting again. And I speak life, health, and wholeness over you.